Once again, welcome to my channel. I am Rupsha Ghosh and today I am going to tell about Aung San Suu Kyi. Let's start the video. Aung San Suu Kyi was born on 19 June 1945 to Burmese parents. Her father, General Aung San, was the founder of the modern Burmese army and is considered to be the father of modern Burma, now known as Myanmar. Her mother, Khin Ki, was a politician and diplomat who was appointed as the Burmese ambassador to India in 1960. Suu Kyi lost her parents when she was only 2 years old. Her life was greatly influenced by her mother and also by visitors having diverse political opinions and ideologies who visited her residence. She was also influenced by Mahatma Gandhi's philosophy of non-violence. When her mother was appointed ambassador to India, Suu Kyi also came with her to Delhi. She first completed her schooling from the Convent of Jesus and Mary and then completed a degree in political science from Lady Sri Ram College, New Delhi. Then she went to England for a bachelor's degree in philosophy, politics and economics from St. Hugh's College in Oxford. Here, she met her future husband, Dr. Michael Arris, who was a leading author on Bhutanese, Tibetan and Himalayan culture and wrote numerous books on Buddhism. They lived in Oxford and have two sons, Alexander and Kim. In 1988, Suu Kyi returned to Burma to look after her ailing mother. However, she stayed back to start a peaceful, pro-democratic movement against the military rule of General Nevin. She formed a party called National League for Democracy, which was won 59% of the votes in the general election in 1990. Her party would have formed the government but was not allowed to do so by the military rulers. She was instead placed under house arrest. She remained under house arrest in Burma for almost 15 years from 20 July 1989 until her recent release on 13 November 2010. Becoming one of the world's most prominent political prisoners, in 1991, Suu Kyi won the Nobel Peace Prize, but since she was under house arrest, Suu Kyi was not permitted to travel to Oslo to receive the same. She remained in detention. She had the choice and withdraw from politics, leave Burma and set herself free. However, Alexander and Kim accepted the Nobel Prize on behalf of their mother. Suu Kyi announced that she would use the award money of $1.3 million to establish a health and education trust for Burmese people. She finally accepted the Nobel Peace Prize 21 years after she had won it on the Oslo City Hall in 1992. She was awarded the Jawaharlal Nehru's Award for International Understanding by the Government of India. Suu Kyi was also presented the Congressional Gold Medal, which is the highest civilian honor in the United States of America. In 1995, she met her husband, Dr. Michael Arris, for the last time. He was diagnosed with cancer and died in 1999, without meeting his beloved wife in March 2013. Suu Kyi was re-elected as the chairman of the National League for Democracy, NLD. The party she founded 35 years ago, she became the first ever state councillor of Myanmar on 6 April 2016. Aung San Suu Kyi dedicated her life for the betterment of Burmese people and fought against the injustice suffered by them at the hands of the military regime. So everyone, thank you the videos and share. Before leaving, subscribe my channel, press the bell icon and like my video. Bye everyone.